upon a time, there was a little baby born in far, far away in the Philippine Islands. She had three brothers and a mother and a dad. But her life was not so good. Why? Because she had to work so hard. She had to take out the trash, clean the house, and her name was Gloria. So, Gloria, do this. Gloria, do that. She had a hard life. Then, one day, she said, "This life is too hard. I'm going to run away from home." So she had a real fancy bracelet. She sold her bracelet and she got on a ship and she went to the big city called Manila. When she was there, she was only about 10 years old, so she wasn't much older than you. And she was a little bit scared because she didn't know where to go. But there was this one family that took in helpers, girls and boys, to help in the house. So they asked her, "Would you like to help in our house?" And she said, "Yes, I'll help. I can help." So when she got in the house, she saw that there were other girls there too. Some of them took out the trash. Some of them did the dishes. And some of them took care of the babies. And some went shopping. So they were like helpers. Gloria's job was to take care of the little baby. She thought, "Oh, this will be a good, easy job." But guess what?
It was hard.
In the middle of the night, "Gloria! Coming, sir! Coming!" So she came and she got the baby and she was trying to take care of the baby. She was telling the baby, "Be quiet, be quiet." And so she, anytime she started to put the baby down, she picked it up again. And she was so sleepy and so tired. And so when she thought the baby was just about going to sleep and put it down, guess what? Oh, she couldn't let the baby wake up the people of the house, the owners. So night after night, she had to stay up and take care of the baby. Oh, she said, "This is no fun. I thought I got away from a hard life. Am I ever going to have a good life?" One day she was down at the market, which is like an open market, like the remate. You know, you can buy fruit and vegetables there. And she was telling the people how she couldn't get any sleep. She had such a hard life. And one lady said, "I saw at a restaurant over here that they were hiring." Well, this time she was about 14 or 15 years old, so she was old enough to work there. So as she started working there, she said, "Oh, this should be easy. All I have to do is take food from the cook and give it to the people in the restaurant. That should be easy." But guess what?
It was hard.
She tried to carry the food, and she got so many dishes that sometimes they would fall down. Crash! "Gloria, what's the matter with you? You're gonna pay for that." "Yes, sir. Yes, sir." She tried to clean it up, and then she would, when she finally learn how to carry the food, then sometimes the men that she would give the food to, they would pinch her on the arm. "Ow! What did you do that for? Ha ha ha!" They thought that was funny. She said, "That hurts. Don't do that. Ha ha!" They would laugh at her. And then she would go back and they would pinch her on the leg. "Ow, what did you do that for?" They thought that was funny. And she said, "Ow, that hurts." And so she did that for like a long time. But she kept saying, why is this happening to me? Why can't I have a good life? Well, finally, one of the customers said, "It looks like you have a very hard life." She says, "Yes." She said, I'm trying to do a good job, but it seems like I always have a miserable circumstances." Well, this lady says, "Do you know how to wash clothes?" She said, "Yes, I can wash clothes. I can do anything." just, I would like to have a nice life. So the lady said, well, there is a place up the road about 2 hours where there's American sailors, and they sometimes hire young ladies to do their laundry. And so she said, yes, I can do it. So she went there, and sure enough, she would go to the sailors and say, do you know how to wash clothes? Yes, I can. She would go down to the river and take the clothes. She didn't have a wash machine, but she would go like this. You know what that is?
Mm-hmm.
Like this?
Scrub.
And on the rocks like this. And she would scrub the clothes, and she'd put it like flat on the rock and fold it and make it nice and smooth with her hand. And then when she would take it back, nice and stacked and clean, then the sailors would say, wow, you did a good job, thank you, and then pay her. And she's kind of like a little bit afraid because everybody used to be mean to her, but they were nice to her. Well, this one particular sailor really did a good job. He really appreciated her work, and he gave her a little bit extra money. And he said, do you know how to like clean a house? And she said, yes, I can clean. He said, well, I live in this apartment, and I'm kind of messy. Can you come and clean it up? And she said, yes, I can do it. So she came in, and she cleaned the house very nicely. Wow, good job. And he would pay her. And then day after day, week after week, she would come in, and she stopped going to the other sailors because this one sailor was so nice to her. Well, one day, the sailor was going to move back to the United States, and it was going to be a very sad time because he was used to Gloria cleaning his house and doing his laundry. So he decided, you know, I think I'm going to have to make a big decision. So he asked her, I'm going to be going back to the United States. Would you marry me? She goes, oh my goodness, I don't know. And her friend says, don't go, they'll be mean to you there.
Not
but
you.
She had to follow her heart. And she said, yes, I will go. So she went back to the United States with this American sailor. And when they got back to the United States, he went back to college and he became a teacher.
Yeah.
He taught for 20 years and then he stopped teaching and he retired.
Yeah.
And then after he retired, he became a substitute teacher.
Yeah.
And then he came one day to California.
Yeah.
And he told that class how he met his wife.
Yeah.
And that is a true story.
Yeah.
Class, how he met his wife.
Yeah!
And that is a true story.
Yeah!